Thank you so much for watching. We're here in conversation with, right now, Erin Molan, pretty in pink as always, and kicking ass, by the way. Well done filling in for Peter last night.
Oh, thank you. That's very kind. I felt like Eric the Eel filling in for Michael Phelps. So. Yes.
And Joe Hildebrand has brought a very big, shiny sausage with him, and we'll explain why in a moment or two.
Okay, that
time.
Is terrifying.
Yeah. Well, look, baby, you know him. You know him. All right, so today in the Hunter Valley, there was the debate between the three major candidates, and what was fascinating was, of course, the Labor candidate says, oh, our secret back door price on carbon, a disincentive to the top 215 polluters, doesn't affect coal mining. But of course, Chris Bowen said it did. So how does this actually work? Here's Laura pushing it today.
Chris Bowen's saying one thing, you are saying another here. So what is the truth? What are voters who are looking at your name on the ballot box expected to think?
I'm saying what I know the plan says, and that is all we need to do.
Mines
is match.
Will not be affected.
Mines will not be affected by this.
So, Joe, how does the candidate know more than the shadow minister?
Oh, he's a very, very smart man. this is policy that was introduced by Tony Abbott. This is coalition policy. It's exactly the same. You can accuse the ALP of me-tooism, but it's exactly the same as what they've got. And I think where they've got
it's
their...
It's a switch that they've never thrown, I think that they are deciding to throw.
I think where they've got their wires crossed is Bowen saying, look, all the 215 companies it applies to, the coal mines fall into that category, but there is also wiggle room. They can sit down and negotiate and sort out a way to...
So it is a solution to climate change or not, Erin?
Look, Joe is just like the Nationals candidate who had to step in and explain to the Labor candidate how their own policy actually bloody works. This is terrifying. It's another example. You have to know it to be able to sell it. They don't know what they're selling. He does not understand how it works. And look, I think...
Well, they do, and they're just not telling us.
Either or, both are as bad as each other. He actually looks like a good bloke. He looks like he's got noble intentions. He's just running for the wrong party, I think.
Well, and he's got the whole rock star look, and, you know, he's bigger than everyone else, and, you know, blah, 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 the whole sort of big show look. That's great, but it ain't WWE, right? It's some people writing the freaking laws for the rest of the country.
But the reason why there is no hard and fast policy position that they can point to is because the policy is not a hard and fast policy. The whole policy is predicated on
the bloke who wrote the policy said yes.
No, but...
Everyone else is saying he didn't.
No, he's saying that they are in that category, but that category includes being able to negotiate based on the individual circumstances of your company.
Would you bet your house on Albo with such logic?
Already have.
Would you bet your house on Albo, Erin?
That is a hell no. Also, I think guaranteeing 10,000 jobs is not a smart move either, because nobody can really do that.